I get way too many questions from aspiring data scientists regarding machine learning, like what parts of machine learning they should learn more about to get a job. And I don't want to disappoint you, but the thing is that when you get started as a junior, 95% of your projects won't be about machine learning. At least that's a rough average. So what parts of machine learning should you learn more about when preparing for your first job? Well, none. Okay, that's not true. There are some parts that you will have to know about, and I will get back to that soon. But first, I want to explain to you the reasons behind my answer. Hi, I'm Tomi Mester from Data36, and let's get started. So, machine learning is not easy. In fact, the easiest part of it is the coding part. There are tons of awesome libraries in Python like NumPy, Pandas, SciPy, scikit-learn, TensorFlow, and many more that make the job of a data scientist much easier. But even so, you can't ignore the statistical and business considerations behind these machine learning algorithms and projects. And to make no mistakes, you should have a few years of experience too. And that means that machine learning projects are not really for freshly starting data scientists. You can still get involved in one, sure, but most likely you will be asked to support a senior data scientist by preparing the project, cleaning the data, writing smaller modules in the code, and so on. Working on these minor parts will also help you to see how that senior data scientist approaches the problems. As I said, you will learn machine learning by doing it on the job. And that leads us back to the things that I always say about learning data science. The best way to prepare to get your first data scientist position is not focusing heavily on machine learning, but to master the basic skills, being fluent with Python and SQL, understanding the business logic behind simpler analytical methods, being familiar with the basics of statistics, practicing and experiencing the pain of working with a raw and unclean dataset, learning how to automate, and so on. But with that being said, it's still worth knowing a few machine learning algorithms and concepts. Why? Three reasons. Through this, you can understand better how machine learning works in general. Once you get the concept of a simpler model, it will be much easier to understand a more complex one later. Two, as I said, as a junior data scientist, maybe you will have to support a senior data scientist's work in a machine learning project. If so, you will have to be familiar with the basic concepts, even if you don't know all the tiny details of the exact algorithms she uses. And three, it can still happen that you will get smaller prediction tasks as a junior data scientist, and you can do these on your own if you learn a few basic algorithms. If you ask me, you should learn only three machine learning models for now: linear and polynomial regressions for prediction, random forest or decision tree for classification, and a clustering algorithm like k-means or something. Let's see the first one, linear and polynomial regression for prediction. A simple task that I got as a junior data scientist was this. We have 3 years of data about our website usage and support tickets. Please figure out, based on the trends, how many new support agents should we hire. And you can complicate this task as much as you want, but the truth is that I was able to give a pretty accurate prediction by using a simple line-fitting model. And when it comes to line-fitting, the simplest machine learning algorithm you can use is polynomial regression. It can be done in Python, for instance, using the NumPy library. And polynomial regression is great. It's easy to implement it, easy to understand it. So as I see it, it's the best first machine learning concept that an aspiring data scientist should learn. In the description, I added a very detailed article with code and with a downloadable Jupyter notebook about linear regression in Python to help you get started. So check that out. And let's head over to the second machine learning model you should learn, which is random forest or decision tree. Another easy task that I got in my first year as a data scientist was this. Please review the different user behaviors in our database and try to come up with a method to flag users who are likely to cancel their subscriptions. There are many ways to solve this problem, but at its core, this is a classification task. Classification is one level trickier than prediction was, still, it's worth understanding how it works. From the perspective of coding, the easiest algorithm you can use is random forest. It is part of the scikit-learn library, and it's not too hard to implement either. But the catch is that to exactly understand the logic of the random forest algorithm is a bit tricky. At least this is what I have seen for the students I work with in my 6-week data science course. So I usually recommend learning the concept of the model called decision tree first. Especially that there is an awesome visual online tutorial for it, which again, I linked in the description. And let's talk about the third machine learning algorithm you should learn as an aspiring data scientist, which is for clustering. And recently, I ran into an interesting question regarding my data science blog, data36.com. I wanted to build user segments based on what articles different users read. I've used a clustering algorithm to do so, which automatically detected 5 typical user segments based on their reading behaviors. And you can run into similar tasks as a junior as well. And it usually can be solved by using clustering algorithms. One of the most well-known clustering algorithms is K-means. It's also easy to interpret and implement in Python, so it's worth taking a look at that too. Just so you know, I ended up using a more complex algorithm for the test that I mentioned. It was with the NetworkX Python library. It's a graph-based clustering solution. You shouldn't learn about it right now. I was just so excited creating this that I couldn't not mention this here. Anyways, if you know these 3 machine learning algorithms, linear and polynomial regressions, decision tree or random forest, and k-means clustering, you will do just fine as a junior data scientist. Well, in your first year at least. And as I said, it doesn't mean that you won't have to learn new algorithms later on the job. In fact, it's pretty likely that you will have to. Once you have a solid understanding of the fundamentals, you can specialize in many directions. Natural language processing, deep learning, predictive analytics, and many more. There are so many different directions and specializations within data science, and each and every of these can be turned into a very successful career. For instance, if you happen to start to work on self-driving cars, naturally, you will become very advanced in deep learning, and maybe you won't learn anything about natural language processing during your career, but that's just fine. And that's another reason to let this work itself out over the years and not spend too much time with machine learning before getting your first job. So what fields of machine learning should an aspiring data scientist learn and practice more? Only the basic ones, simple regression, classification, and clustering models. And right now, you should focus more on being better with the basic stuff, Python, SQL, data cleaning, automations, and so on. Leave the more advanced machine learning algorithms until later. You'll be able to learn them on the job while getting more senior in data science. But with that being said, this is the end of this episode. If you liked it, please subscribe, leave a rating or a comment. And remember, the best way to get notified about new episodes is always the Data36 newsletter list, the only place where I really communicate to my audience right now. You can subscribe to it at data36.com/newsletter. And hey, if you do so, you will get access to a lot of free learning materials too, including my free mini course called How to Become a Data Scientist. Thank you for listening. I'm Tomi Mester from data36.com. Until next time.